Hello, grooming lovers. Today we have the biggest and the most matted Maltese ever. First of all, you can see how big that guy is. He is like 5 Maltese. He's probably a mix, but when they were calling me, they were making an appointment for a Maltese, and this boy came. He's only about a year ago. He seems sweet, and now I'm going to show you how matted he is. Look at that leg. Look at this layer and layer of hair. The mats are everywhere, not just on the legs. This area is super matted. You cannot see the skin. The ears are matted, of course. This area where the leash is and the collar is super matted. Everything, guys, just everything is super, super matted. Look at that area. It's awful. Poor dog. This side also. Just look at that. It's crazy. I don't know why people get this type of dog. If they are not going to take care of it. It's just crazy. I'm gonna show you this leg again and this area again. Just too much, guys, it's too much. And I'm just going to take my cell phone, make some thumbnail pictures and then proceed. Want to take a good picture of this area too. Okay, it's enough. Okay, I'm going to take my tan blade. I'm going to put some oil because this is a very, very thick fur. Okay, let's start. I'm going to find a place where he is not matted, like this area too, because you cannot start from a matted area. As I said, he seems like a good boy. Hopefully I won't have any problems with him being aggressive or something like that. And guys, if you think that this does not hurt, you're wrong. This is all tied up. Imagine that you're being pulled in 100 directions, that your skin is being pulled. It is a torture. It is definitely a torture of an animal. Poor dog. Luckily he is fine for now, he cooperates, hopefully he'll stay that way. But guys, even if he did not cooperate, it will be reasonable. Because this is not pleasant for him, definitely. Okay, you're okay. Going to take these scissors. These are my old scissors that I use in these cases to cut this matted hair. And I can barely find a place where he's not matted. Guys, please don't let your dog be in this condition. Okay guys, I'm just going to take this cell phone again. This is my girlfriend's old cell phone, which I use only for thumbnails. And I just want to make a good thumbnail. It's okay. I'm just whistling to try to make him look at the camera. Okay, let's see what I have here. Okay guys, this is fine. And I'm just going to start. I mean to start at so many places where he's not matted, because it's just hard to do it the regular way when I groom first the body and the legs and blah blah blah. In these cases there are no rules, and normally guys, when I'm grooming, you can see I'm going down to here, because the length of the hair that I'm leaving is not the same if I'm going down the hair and up the hair. But in these cases, when the hair is matted like that, the only thing I care is getting the top of the dog. And if I have to go in different directions, I don't care if everything will not be even and smooth and like that. I just don't care. I just want to get everything off the dog. And he's super sweet. As you can see, he's sweet boy, cooperates. Even though I'm sure this is not pleasant for him at all. I'm literally digging under the mattress here. You can see this is just crazy. Look at that, it's all in one piece. Okay, don't eat your hair, please. Okay. Just checking if the blade is too hot. It's not. You're okay. Okay, let's spray this a little bit, guys. This is a spray that cools, lubricates, and disinfects the blade. It is great, I recommend it. You're okay. And I'm probably going to make him all short, like the head. complete everything short, but we will see. Maybe I will be able to save a little bit on the head, but I shaved this area, so probably there won't be much to do. Save. See? I'm just being careful on the ears because the skin is thinner there. You can see, guys, his hair is clean, and that's because he's probably, the owners probably bathed him. They definitely never brushed him, but I don't know how they dry this hair. Even with a professional blow dryer and everything, it would be like very, very hard, almost impossible to completely dry this hair, this mess. So I don't know how they do it and why they do it. I mean, I don't know. You can take a look at that. Go on. Okay, let's spray this blade a little bit more. You see, his private area is also matted. I don't know what to do with the tail. I mean, this area is not matted. I could probably save it, but this area is super matted. So I'll decide when I finish his legs. See, his private area is just disgusting, and yeah, the tail, he has a lot of mats, and okay, I don't know, I'm just going to do the private area, then I'll see about the tail. This area that is left is not matted, so I'm probably going to leave something on his head and not just shave the entire head. I probably am going to save the tail. Okay, okay, let's take the template back on. Okay. And finish the shave down. Okay. Okay. Now I'm going to clip his nails. Hopefully he'll be fine for that too. Good boy, good boy. Guys, none of this hurt. I mean, clipping the nails does not hurt. You can see that this nail is huge. Okay. Good boy. Okay, the nails are done. He was super cute, super fine. And now I'm going to do his paw pads, and later I'm going to pull the hair from the ears. Okay. No. Okay, let's do the paw pads. I'm shaving this hair because the dirt will stick to it when the dog is outside. It is also very, very slippery for the dog when the... when the dog is walking. Okay, that leg is done. Okay, that's fine. He's kind of tired from all of that. It's probably been stressful to him because he was super matted. And this probably feels great for him because there's been a while since he could feel someone touching him from all of that, those mats. And he's one great dog. Let's just say that. Okay. Last paw pad. Okay, that's fine. Now I'm going to pull this here from the ear canal, and I'm going to use this ear powder because that hair is slippery and this makes the better grip, makes the hair not slippery. And he's just doing great. Guys, we're pulling this hair from an ear canal because when there's no hair in the ear canal, it allows the ear to breathe. And when the ear can breathe, I mean when the ear can flow through the ear, it decreases the chances of ear getting infected. Okay, the next thing, because I don't want him to look like a schnauzer, I'm going to take this hair off. And I'm going to leave just a little on his muzzle. I'm gonna do around his eyes. No, I'm going to do that later. For now, just going to get this shorter before the bath. Guys, this is the shave down before the bath. We always shave, I mean shave. When we are grooming the dog short, we Let's say shave the dog before the bath, give the dog a bath, brush the head and the tail, because those are not getting shaved, but those are getting clipped by scissors. And guys, after the bath, we shave the body again, make it all nice and even, and do the head and the tail with scissors. And I'm just doing this because it would be easier to brush later and to wash. Okay, this is fine. For now, so we did the nails, the ears, we shaved the dog, we did the sanitary area, and I did some clipping on his head, I mean scissoring on his head. So I'm going to give him a bath, and I'm not going to film that, and I'm going to dry him, brush that tail and this little head, and I'll see you after that. Okay guys, so we're done with the bathing and the drying. I also brushed his face and I was able to save the tail. I made the tail shorter before brushing because it was too long. It was like this long and that long, so I made it shorter before brushing so it would be easier to brush. And now I'm going to take the scissors. This is a thing I normally do before I shave the dog again. Take the scissors, work around the paws. Okay, now taking this hair that is between the toes out and doing it with scissors. He's super sweet dog. He's been great for the bath, great for the blow dryer, for brushing, for everything. This dog should have been given a medal. Okay, you're heavy. Okay, that area is fine. Now I'm going to take the 15 blade and finish the sanitary area. Guys, we shave these areas because when the dog poops and pees, the urine and the poop will not stick to the hair. Okay. Okay, that's fine. I'm just going to take this baby powder and put it on his private area, because he's probably going to get itchy. That area was matted, and who knows when was the last time he was groomed and was he ever shaved in that area. So I'm putting a lot of baby powder. Okay. He's such a great dog. Okay, playtime is over. Taking the tan blade, and I'm going to start grooming him. I'm using my sticker brush to brush this hair up. And guys, that powder that I used, it's not the ear powder. The ear powder is different. This is the regular powder that people use. Okay, that's fine. Okay. He's heavy. Okay, the back legs are done. Now I'm going to do the body. He's all white. I don't remember the last time I put so much powder on the dog. Okay, let's do the tail while this blade is cooling down. I'm going to do the tail with scissors. Okay, a little bit more. And because that blade is still cooling, I'm going to do the end of the ears with scissors. I'm holding my fingers at the end of the skin so I will not cut the skin. Okay. You have to be really careful when the dog is moving his head like these guys, because he moves suddenly. He probably does not like the sound of scissors near his ears. And he can move suddenly, and if I'm not protecting the skin with my fingers, I can definitely cut the skin. Okay. I'm going to fix these areas. You can see how the hair is sticking out. I'm also being super careful around this area. Okay. Okay, the tail is done, back legs, the body. Now let's do the front legs and the head. Okay, let's do the armpit. When I'm doing the armpit, I'm being really careful. You can see how skin, how glimsy that skin is. Okay, let's finish this leg and do the head. Okay, we're done with the body. I'm going to take 8.5 blade again and do this upper part of the head. Guys, when a dog was in the condition that this guy was, you cannot make some haircut out of the hair. but at least he won't be mad anymore. He won't be in pain. Okay. I'm gonna carefully do the eyelashes. I'm going to make his muzzle short, but I'm not going to shave it completely like the rest of the head. Try to give him some looks, some haircut. Okay, that's it with scissors. Going to take the fan blade on and finish his ears, and we are done. Okay guys, I think that we are done. I think that he looks funny and cute. I mean, at least he's not matted anymore, which is great. He's not in pain anymore. Okay, let's put him down. You're a good boy. Good boy. Probably feels great for him that he can feel someone touching him. He is probably itchy everywhere because he was matted and he's not anymore. And this is something new for him. Thank you so much for watching guys, thank you for supporting me, and hopefully I'll see you soon.